already in his DNA. No, the elite, man, they got all kind of viruses brewing for you, motherfucker, man.
Viruses you never heard of.
Don't you know they have bubonic plague? They have the bubonic... These devils have bubonic plague locked away. They can just release it at any moment.
That's in the curses. We get that, man.
People are so stupid. Just like they don't realize that nuclear missiles actually exist. What do you think they're gonna do with those nukes?
Right.
Where you at? The pigs are doing around. Doing around. Yeah. There's a lot of curses. We on some curses right now. It's a curse to have to look at these all these uneducated fools. All these zombies. You know what I mean? Cause really the zombie outbreak's already started. Cause most people are zombies, man.
Here's some. Deuteronomy 28 and 21. The Lord shall make pestilence cleave unto thee until he hath consumed thee from off the land whither thou goest to possess it.
Yeah, what's that pestilence? That's one of my diseases. I should need to look that up in Hebrew. No, that I'll do it later. But I do need to look that up. I just keep a mental note. Read that again.
The Lord shall make the pestilence cleave unto thee until he hath consumed thee from off the land whither thou goest to possess it.
So you know that happened back in the late Dark Ages. There was something known as the Black Plague that wiped out nearly half the population or more. Okay, it was just countless deaths. The Black Plague, it just fucked up the whole planet, man. Keep going. If y'all don't know anything about the Black Death, what do they call it, the Black Plague, go Google that. Read about the Black Death.
The Lord shall smite thee with a consumption, and with a fever, and with an inflammation, and with an extreme burning.
I was just thinking too, you know, the Black Death happened, back 1300s. Well, there was a couple occurrences that kept popping back up. But that was before the time of genetic engineering. That was before the time of the age of science. But now we have motherfucking scientists brewing up diseases in a laboratory. Because before, these diseases popped up naturally. So if we got people out here creating diseases, that automatically increases the percentage rate that is actually going to happen. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The probability rate. It increases the probability that an outbreak is going to happen. Because it's going to happen. We got scientists creating all kind of diseases in laboratories all over the world, man. And they going to release some diseases on this population. And they going to exterminate all kind of people, man.
They sure will.
It's coming. Believe that. It's coming.
Yeah.
Why do you think they're making all these movies about zombie viruses? About outbreak, contagion?
You see that the other day it came up that now the government is saying that they made a mistake in saying that it is something with this zombie shit, man. It is something that's going to come, that's going to happen.
It is.
They're coming out now.
Oh yeah, go ahead.
The Lord shall smite thee with a consumption, and with a fever, and with an inflammation, and with an extreme burning, and with the sword, and with blasting, and with mildew, and they shall pursue thee until thou perish.
You know, if there's an outbreak, what happens if there's a virus outbreak, an epidemic? What's going to happen? Martial law is going to happen. So right after you get that virus, then they're going to hit you with a sword. What a giant truck's making all this money delivering all these goods. So yeah, when there's a virus outbreak, martial law is coming right behind it. Okay? And martial law is gonna come regardless if there's a virus outbreak or not. You already seen the news. Y'all seen the news about they're setting up. They have tanks down there in St. Louis. They got a whole army brigade down in St. Louis.
Yeah.
They're getting ready to set up martial law in St. Louis. But they were saying that they're about to put an army brigade in every United, every major U.S. city.
It was somewhere else other than St. Louis, too.
Yeah, well, they're saying they're going to station a whole brigade in every U.S. city. Yeah. They're going to get ready for martial law.
They just enacted another group here in Columbus. So I can't remember what it is, though, but it's a military, some military camp up north probably.
Y'all said you seen tanks there.
Yeah, there's National Guard all over here. Army Reserve.
Let them get busy. That's what we're waiting for. That's what we're praying for.
I say they building a lot here in Columbus, man. I don't know why they're building all these new freeways in Columbus. If the economy's so bad, they're not building anything anywhere else in this country. But in Columbus, they're building like crazy. What are they building for? Y'all know why the freeway system was originally built?
Probably military purpose.
Yeah, the freeway was built by, it was started by Dwight D. Eisenhower. And he was a general. He was the top general during World War II. And he said he needed a road system in America for military purposes.
That's right.
So the main purpose of the freeway system is for the military, not for the civilians.
That's right.
It was built for the military. So I'm thinking that's what they're going to use. They're building up new freeways in Columbus.
Yeah, they're upgrading them, make them wider, so make tanks, big. More tanks.
Right.
You know.
They're making it easier for them to deploy their tanks and to deploy all their machinery.
Yeah, a lot of that machinery is fucking huge.
Yeah.
Shit. A lot of it's big as fuck.
So that's why a lot of people don't understand that. They think the freeways were built for the common man. No, they were not.
No.
They were built for tanks. There's a freeways were built for the military.
Yeah.
You can look it up. That's mainstream history.
That's what runs this country, the military complex,
yep.
Industrial complex.
Because Dwight D. Eisenhower, he knew the history of the Roman Empire. What did the Roman Empire have that made it successful? It had roads. What were the roads for? Were the roads for the people? No, it was for the military.
Sophisticated roads.
Yeah, the roads were for the legions. That's who the roads were for.
Here we go. Deuteronomy 28. I'm going to stop jumping at 58. If thou would not observe to do all the words of this law that is written in this book, that thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name, the Lord thy power, then the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful.
He gonna make the plagues wonderful. And I don't think that's wonderful in a My Little Pony sense, like Rainbow Bright. You know,
right.
It's not like some kind of magical fairy tale wonderful. That's a wonderful death, a wonderful destruction.
Yeah. Then the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful, and the plagues of thy seed, even the great plagues in a blown continuance.
Did it say the plagues of thy seed?
Yep.
So that means children, right?
That's right.
Because people will say, how can you guys say children are going to get destroyed?
Fuck these nuts.
That's a fact of life. Well, children are already getting destroyed. The government is poisoning your children with all this food. Look at all the candy. All the candy in the store has bones in it, pig bones in it. It has gelatin in it. Mm. And that's all against the laws of the Bible. You're not allowed to eat pork. And almost every popular candy that you feed to your children in the store has pork in it. It's poison. If it doesn't have pork in it, it has something else demonic in it.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're shooting your children up with vaccinations, forcing your children to go to school. So your children are, your seed is already
getting destroyed. Oh, it's so my kids won't get sick.
Right.
Dumbass.
So your seed's already getting destroyed. Oh. Half the drinks you feed your children got high fructose corn syrup in it. That causes fucking heart attacks. That's what they call the food version of crack. Artificial sugar made from corn. Kind of fucked up shit is that? Keep going.
Then the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful, and the plagues of thy seed, even great plagues, and of long continuance.
A long continuance. I mean, it's not just going, all the plagues just going to come and then it's going to be over next week.
Yeah, you're going to take a shot or take a pill.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Like these bitches, yeah. They take a pill for every time they have sex, they take a whole bunch of different pills.
Right.
Hey, someone just called. Is that like
Philip
a number from Dave?
Fill up on pills. No.
Oh, shit. Oh, that ain't it.
Yeah, we have heard. Have you heard from Dave?
That
one. He ain't got no minutes
on his phone. Oh, I didn't know.
You gotta
that
just
might
go
have
get
been
it.
Him.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, you gotta go get it. Just go get it.
Sorry for that. Sorry, Dave. If you're watching the video, we're sorry. We apologize.
Sorry, he could have got a hold of us.
You're right.
So. I thought something might have happened. I didn't know what was up.
Okay. And of long continuance and sour sicknesses and of long continuance. Moreover, he will bring upon thee all the diseases of Egypt, which thou was afraid of, and they shall cleave unto thee.
All the diseases of Egypt. Just like when the Lord plagued Egypt. He hit them with them, they hit them with like fleas and locusts and all kind of mess.
Yeah. Frogs.
Gave them all kind of diseases, killed the firstborn son.
That's crazy.
So that and a whole lot more is coming here, man.
Falling out of the sky. Normally gonna fall out of the sky. That's crazy.
Now we are, fuck, that's loud. Because now we in modern day Egypt, you know what I'm saying? Hey, it's gonna get hit with plagues just like ancient Egypt. See that like that. Let's go. Let's go.
Also, every sickness and every plague.
He said every sickness and every plague.
Which is not written in the book of this law. Them will the Lord bring unto thee until you be destroyed.
Until you be destroyed. So the Lord said he's going to destroy you with plagues. You think God's a liar? I don't think so. And it just so happens that your government that you love so much have probably millions upon millions of different plagues locked away in their little laboratories. And they're going to be released. You already had those little anthrax scares. We're in the anthrax scares, mailing letters with anthrax to people.
That's good.
That is good. Oh, yeah, let's go back to that testimony. We should bring us, I should bring some documents on the plague. Oh, yeah. A whole video on that, man. You're gonna get a bunch of there's people that ain't gonna believe it until we show them documents, you know what I mean?
Yeah, 2 Thessalonians 3:7. For yourselves know how you ought to follow us, for we have behaved not ourselves disorderly among you. Neither did we eat any man's bread for naught, but wrought with labor and travail night and day, that we might not be chargeable of to any of you. Not because we have not power, but to make ourselves an example unto you to follow us.
Yeah, so that's an old saying, man. You gotta lead by example. You know what I'm saying? You claim to be making the world a better place. You gotta lead by example.
For even when we were with you, this we commanded you, that if any would not work, neither should he eat.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, and another good point too is one of the reasons we come out here and teach is hopefully it put the spirit on some of y'all to go out and teach too, you know, or make videos on YouTube. You just gotta push this word whichever way you can push it. You know what I mean? That's what you call leading, being an example, leading by example. You gotta push the truth. If you have the truth, you just can't sit on the truth. You gotta push it by any means necessary. All means, you know what I mean? Keep going.
This is treasure you can't keep in. This is treasure you can't keep locked up in a safe. You got this treasure you're supposed to go out there and share.
You gotta go hustle it, man. Double your money,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, you wanna talk about reading up?
Because yeah. Jacob is a hustler, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you gotta go hustle this truth, man. Yeah, go hustle the truth. Just like you go out there and sell CDs on the corner. Now, we used to do that. I used to go sell my CDs on the corner. Like, yo, say you want to buy my new CD, son? They don't do that no more. They use MP3s. You know, back in the old school. But now we ain't hustling CDs. Now we hustling truth.
Hustling scriptures.
And we giving it away for free. You know what I'm saying? We ain't asking $5 a scripture. You know what I mean? These scriptures are free, man.
Ain't pay, right, passing that pot around several times, four or five times, you know, within an hour. Man, y'all can keep your motherfucking money.
Right, we didn't got a pot. We had a jug we used to bring out here for money, but nobody ever gave us no money, so we stopped bringing it.
We only brought it like two times.
Yeah. Go ahead. Ain't nobody fucking giving us shit, I can tell you that.
Even when we were with you, this we commanded you. That if any would not work, neither should he eat. But we hear that there are some which walk among you disorderly, walking not at all, but are busybodies.
Out there kicking, going to the popular shopping mall where all the restaurants at, hanging out with your friends, your high school buddies, posting on Facebook, meet us here and there. But, you know, outdoing foolishness when they should be outdoing this work.
They got one foot in the truth and one foot in the world.
Busybodies. After one party is ended, they go into another one, you know?
Thinking they can join. That's what scriptures say, though, the hand joining the hand, the wicked shall not go unpunished.
Oh, yeah, now that you mention that. Oh, this is bugged out. Don't you know white folks now is coming out saying, because they're white, it's unfair that they have extra privileges, like they can go to any neighborhood without getting pulled over like we get pulled over. They get jobs before we get jobs. They saying it's unfair now, you know? And I, what came to my mind is the scripture of, they shall complain of an ungodly father.
Oh, yeah?
That's some bugged out shit. You ain't hear about that yet? It's been on 610 all week. That's crazy as hell. It's unfair.
And a lot of these white people, they're not white anyway. Yeah. A lot of them are stupid.
They're making a big thing out of it too right now too. That's why y'all ain't heard about that yet.
I know what you're talking about.
They're worried now. They're seeing their society falling, so they're scared now.
All these yuppies up, what do you call them? Alex Jones calls them the trendies. The goddamn Edomites. That's funny as hell. Yeah. The trendies.
That's what he called them too.
The left wing nutcases.
Let's not get off point, man.
Oh, he's cool. Yeah, because they do see their shit falling. That's why you got an Occupy Wall Street popping up. Occupy Wall Street's nothing but a bunch of rich white kids, man. You know, who grew up with everything handed to them. So now here it is, the economy's imploding, and they don't know what to do. They're freaking out because they've had everything handed to them their whole life. You know, us, we've been poor our whole life, you know? I grew up in the ghetto, still live in the ghetto. Probably die in the ghetto.
I grew up with not having shit. I still ain't got shit. You know, that's fine though. That's all right, because that's how it's supposed to be.
Because material possessions don't mean shit anyway, man.
What the scriptures say, this is not your rest. It is polluted.
Yeah, it's polluted. It's not your rest. And he tell you it's not your rest, because that's why we're tired. This shit, living in this world will wear your spirit out, man. Yeah, right. Yeah, vex your spirit living in a fucked up society like this.
Every day, continuously. So that's why it's easy not to go. It's easy to not step out the door and come out and look at these goddamn fools. I don't like my spirit been fixed.
You know what's crazy too? I'm surprised the suicide rate ain't higher. All these rich people, they lose that money, they kill themselves.
It's high with the military though.
Oh, it's very high with the military. That's why I think they're doping the soldiers up with all kind of drugs and messing their brains up.
Military blowing their own goddamn heads off.
Yeah, all the people in the military, them all jakes.
Dumbasses. Well, that's what they get for taking their foolish, simple ass in the military in the first place.
That's good though. I mean, if you
better off blowing your fucking head off, your goddamn head off.
Only good thing to come out of it is they get to kill Muslims. That's it. I guess you can look at it a positive side.
Yeah.
But they're not doing it for a good reason. They're not going over to the Middle East to destroy all Muslims, okay? No. They're going over there to take the resources and to rob them for everything. You know what I mean? If they really claim to be on like a, some kind of Christian expedition, they would have went over to Jerusalem and destroy that goddamn dome on a rock, and they would have destroyed that shit, and they would have destroyed all the mosques. They don't go over there and destroy the mosque, do they? So that's how we know that it's not a holy war they're fighting. Well, they're over there just raping and robbing for no good reason. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just being a bunch of damn devils. Now, if we went over there to battle people, we're going to destroy the mosques, especially that damn dome on the rock. We're going to destroy the goddamn Kaaba stone. We're going to take a hammer to that motherfucker, a sledgehammer, smash that bitch to pieces. And that damn cube, we're going to catch that cube on fire with all the people dancing around it. We're going to smash them to pieces. But the government ain't doing that. No, no, they're not.
It's going to take the Most High to do it. He's going to send a missile over there.
That's how you know it's bullshit. Because people try to, because they got these stupid assholes. They're saying that America's a Christian nation and that they're fighting a holy war against the Muslims. These people are a bunch of dumbasses, man.
Even the Arabs know this goddamn white man.
Yeah.
He saw this over
the cross. He don't even believe in God. He don't give a fuck about Christ or Muhammad. He could care less what you believe in. He just wants all your money. He wants all your resources. That's all he cares about.
But you a slave.
Oh yeah, we are way off topic. Let's get back to Thessalonians.
Now them that are such we command and exhort by our Lord Yahweh Shai, that with quietness they work and eat their own bread. But ye brethren, be not weary in the well doing.
So don't be weary to do good. You know what I'm saying? Teaching the word is a good thing. Don't be scared to teach this word. Actually, when you start teaching this word, you get bold in the spirit. When you start teaching this word, the Lord put a special kind of spirit on you that kind of make you go crazy and make you so you're not afraid of anybody. You're ready to take on a whole army, a whole gang. You know what I mean? You just feel invincible. You can have 50 people come up against you, and the Lord put a spirit on you, you won't even give a fuck if they kill you. You just don't.
Them motherfuckers out.
Because you get so hard in the spirit, you just get bold, man. You
just don't motherfuckers out.
Hey, get Psalms 104. Get Psalms 104, bro. Now hold that for a second. I like that point. Get Psalms 104 and start from the top. Actually, let's just get Psalms 104 and start. Go to the part where it says ministers are flying. It's like 104 or 3 or 5 or something like that. It makes an angel spirits.
Yeah.
Read that.
You start there?
Well, you can start wherever you want.
Start at the top.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, because that's
Psalms 104 and start at the top. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my power, thou art very great. Thou art clothed with honor and majesty. Who covers thyself with light as with a garment, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain, who layeth the beams of his chamber in the waters, who maketh the clouds of his chariots, who walketh upon the wings of the wind.
And that scripture right there proves UFOs to be true. Because it said that the Lord makes the cloud his chariot, and he walks upon the wings of the wind.
Who maketh his angel spirits, his ministers, a flaming fire.
I read that again.
Who maketh his angel spirits.
So angels are not, they don't have physical bodies like us. They're spirits. Keep going.
Yeah, come down and have a sex with Mary.
Yeah, that proves that angels didn't have sex with Mary. Oh, that disproves fallen angels. How can fallen angels have been angels if the angels are spirits and they have celestial bodies? Man, read that again. That disproves fallen angels.
That's right. Who maketh his angel spirits, his ministers, a flaming fire.
So that's why we're a flaming fire. That's why we're not scared of anybody. You know why? Because the Lord put a fire in our spirit.
Ain't scared of nobody.
That's why we got like a fire burning in our spirit.
That's right.
And you can't quench that fire. It just grows and gets bigger. I mean, the fire don't get put out. You know what I mean? That's like when the scriptures say you gotta trim your lamp. You know what I mean? Because that's that fire. We got that fire inside. Because the Lord said he made his ministers, that's us. We minister to the people. He made us a flaming fire. And the scriptures say his word is like fire. That's why we always saying that scripture's fire. You know what I mean? Like bring that fire out. You know?
Yeah, when you see lightning, that's just danger.
Yep. Electricity is an amazing thing.
Yeah, amazing. amazing to see, amazing to feel.
We got electricity going through our bodies. You know what I mean?
That's why we got different blood types. There's different currents.
Yep, there is.
Yep. The sun's gonna be that one. You laying dead on that goo, that gurney or whatever the fuck you call it. What they hit you with when they trying to revive your soul?
Yep. The shock.
Bam! You know, back up. Y'all better back up.
They showed you that in the movie The Matrix. Remember The Matrix?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a girl. That's not a Egyptian girl.
There goes Juggalo, the ring, the riddle box.
She a Juggalo? Juggalo. Yeah, man, I was on YouTube. I call some Juggalo women some Juggahoes. They got mad at me.
What? Yeah, ICP calls them that shit all the time.
I'm like, I thought y'all was down with the clowns. And the clowns say all kind of crazy shit.
And they got mad for
them. Yeah, I thought they was going to like it. Like, hey, what's up? Yeah. I was just trying to get some pussy, you know what I mean? Like, what's up, Juggahoes?
Just trying to get some ass.
Yeah. I thought y'all bitches like being called hoes. I'm mistaken, though.
You are.
Man, you gotta stay away from them Juggalo women though, man.
I never heard of them, bro.
Just stay away. Don't fuck with the Juggalo, man. Bitches ain't right. I can tell you that. That's all I can tell you. Any bitches down with the clowns ain't right. They be heavy into that shit.
They be slitting their wrists late at night and shit.
Painting their face and.
What?
They hit you with a hatchet.
They probably have sex with 2-liter bottles.
Goodness, it's that bad.
Every we're in that bitch we live with, whoever's back in the day.
Oh yeah.
The bitch was a clown. She'd be walking around with face paint on.
Eyeliner and the whole face be black and shit.
That's back. We was living pretty much like a party house, I guess, back in the old school. We was living with a Juggalo. That bitch was hardcore ICP.
That's crazy as hell. Here you go.
It's funny, it was too, they had kicked out. These are fucking weirdos, man.
Look at this picture. Hold on.
Yo, you see your Egyptian girl up there? Mm-hmm. That bitch, that Egyptian girl we talked to one day, she all thick. We used to talk about the Middle East earlier. And another reason why they shouldn't be over there fighting on those wars over there in the Middle East, because a lot of our people scattered over there, man. Because you could go over there to fight them heathens, and you could actually end up shooting one of your brothers and not even know it. Not even know it. Because a lot of them Arabs and the Muslims, they actually Israelites. And that's why, see the Bible, so the Lord did not command us to go out and to shoot people and to kill people. You know what I'm saying? The Lord command is to teach his word. To wake our brothers up, not to go kill them. You know what I'm saying? All right, go ahead. Okay, yeah, show me the scripture where Christ said to go kill everybody.
Here you go. 4:24 Deuteronomy. For the Lord thy power is a consuming fire, even a jealous power.
Huh?
Petition, great cause.
We're reading the Bible. The Bible is more important than that.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not meaning to knock you guys.
It's all right, though, but what you doing?
We're basically trying to take the power out of the hands of the politicians and put it back in the hands of the people.
How's that going to happen?
Basically, we want to stop gerrymandering and stop redistricting the laws so the government can take. I definitely believe I won't be out here all day on
High
Street.
So you don't believe in the Bible?
Right? I do believe in the Bible.
The Bible says that's not going to happen.
I believe in the Bible, but I also believe in facts and also believe in politics. I believe in law.
Okay? Oh, you believe in policies?
Politics.
Oh, politics?
Yes, I believe in that.
What does the word politics mean?
Politics basically means government. That's all I know.
To you.
But where does the word politic come from?
Politics.
You said you believe in politics. That's a Greek. Yeah, politics. That's a Greek word. It comes from the word politics.
Are you guys going to school? Are you guys going to school?
No.
we are prophets of the Lord. We're real prophets of the Lord.
You know what a fraternity is doing? They worship Zeus, Apollo, Dionysus. They're homosexuals. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's a Greek fraternity. Who did the ancient Greeks
worship? Females,
worship?
Males, doesn't matter. They're all homosexuals.
It's only a male-oriented Bible study.
Well, no, the Lord, we're all the Lord's children. But men, it's the men's job to teach. Barack Obama, I need to go sit down.
Hello.
Let me ask you a question.
Petitions for a great cause.
He can't help. This guy, he's wrong.
Brother, here's the scripture.
Yeah. He got to hear the Bible too. He don't want
to
hear that.
Yeah, you just need a husband, baby. That's all you need to focus on.
That husband, that righteous husband,
will get you there.
Barack Obama ain't going to there.
Listen, you know about John the Baptist.
No, sir.
Well, he prepared the way for the Lord before he came, right? That's what we're doing. The same. We're in the spirit of John the Baptist.
Barack Obama's not. You know, Barack Obama just publicly, on national TV, endorsed homosexual marriage. Yeah, he claims to be a Christian. He worships Satan.
I believe love is everywhere.
No, it's not everywhere. It's not everywhere.
That's obvious.
You tell me there's love on these streets. There's no love out here.
Go to the hood. I'm sure you know the hood.
I've never lived in a hood.
Where are you from? I'm from Westerville, actually.
And I believe in this tremendously. Excuse me, guys.
But the Lord's not in these churches. He's not dealing with these churches. That's the problem.
But you say you go to church.
That's in the scriptures also?
What does your church teach you about homosexual marriage?
A lot of the things in the church I don't believe in. I believe in you can worship God your own way.
What does scripture say that?
There is no scripture.
That's not in the scriptures.
You don't have to read the Bible and preach.
You're just so naive.
You're gullible as hell.
They like them young and dumb. That's how they like them.
You're a woman anyway, though. You're just a female that just happened to be a woman. You're still cheap right now, but if you keep fooling with this world, the beauty's going to slip away. It's going to get you. You're important. Yes, it is. That's one. That's strike one. Don't lose that figure. Strike one. The Bible says not to eat.
No, it's Islamic faith. You're a little direct, but you don't believe in faith.
Let's just read some scriptures. You can't. Scriptures here and there. Get back over here, sister.
Where you going, preacher, man?
Come here, Chaka.
No, come on. You got to get it.
Come here, Chaka.
Hey, the Bible said the wicked flee the number of
suits. Are you guys, like, you do something daily? Are y'all college students?
Hell no, we ain't no college students.
Why not hell? I don't believe Christians.
Look, you don't know the Bible.
Terminology.
You've been deceived. Okay, you've been lied to. What's your nationality?
My nationality.
So you're an African and an American?
Yes, sir.
So you know Africa is a continent, and there are many nations within that continent.
Yeah, I know. My name is Asian, so it kind of comes with the territory. I know a lot of continents. Excuse me, guys. She's bugged out, man. She's a piece of work.
Now listen. You just need to be quiet for a minute.
Let's see some scriptures. That's a few scriptures, all right?
And we're going to assign that for you.
If you had any sense in you, which I'm counting on, you would stay here all day.
How do you expect me to follow your faith when you've been down in me?
You've been down in you.
You call me dumb, sir.
No.
This is the Lord's faith. This is his, not ours.
Yes.
We're reading the Bible, okay?
Are you guys like prophets?
Exactly. We're the real prophets of the Bible.
I'm sure it's
reincarnation.
Maybe what is scripture talking about?
Leviticus 11 and 7. And the swine.
You know what a swine is? The swine. Yeah, it's a swine flu comes from the pig. Right, it's a pig.
And the swine, though he divideth the hoof and be clove-footed, yet he cheweth not the cud, he is unclean to you. Of their flesh shall ye not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch, they are unclean to you.
Now, so you don't live in the hood. Okay, so I can't give you.
Okay. I'm not from the hood.
What you mean? You ever heard of a black man reading the Bible that's going to be a threat to you?
Actually, there's a lot of pastors who've been threats, not to me, but
that's a right. That's a pastor. That's a pastor.
But, hey, she'll give her number to an agnostic, an atheist, or a Barack Obama supporter real quick.
You're missing out, girl.
Yeah, yeah. I bet one of.
Where do y'all conduct service?
Right here.
Now, we just read you the scripture.
Let me show it to her.
He looks at you like you're nothing. Because he's an Edomite. Okay, you know what an Edomite is? That's why I asked you your nationality. What's your nationality? You're an Israelite. You know what an Israelite is? An Israelite is a child of the Most High.
I read the Bible. All through the Bible, they mention Israel.
I've heard different stories how the Bible is written by a person.
People deceive you.
The Bible changes the everyday position.
Are you a child of God?
You're a great person anyway. Excuse me, sir, petition.
That's a word that America likes to use a lot. Everybody's great. Every athlete is great. Everything's great.
You're scared. Go watch out.
He's an illegal immigrant.
You don't understand.
He ain't just a heathen.
There's
just
Chinese farm around here.
How is he beautiful when he's a heathen?
Everyone's beautiful.
No. The Lord tells you that his people are the ones that got the salt of the earth.
The
other people are like spit.
Did you see the way he looked at you? He looked at you like...
You gotta open your eyes, girl.
He's like, what are you saying?
You look good.
When you're a Christian, you see the good in everybody.
No.
Everybody's not really perfect. That's what Christians are here for.
Who are the Christians?
Me! I'm a Christian.
Oh, you're
I'm
a Christian. But you said you support Barack Obama.
I do support Barack Obama.
But you know Barack Obama supports abortion. Is it okay to kill babies? Now you know.
I don't believe in
murder.
I don't believe in human beings. I believe in the Lord. So I know, if I know I'm living my faith, it don't matter what everybody else in this world is doing.
No, but you're supporting them with your work.
Here you go. This is Isaiah 29 and 13. Y'all listen very carefully.
By you doing what you're doing, you're enslaving yourself.